Like we discussed, so we have covered basically 8 sessions. So that was part of Shraddha 1, which we have completed. And now we are on the session 10. So session 9 is actually Vyuha, where we have multiple groups who will join together, and then we will have a lecture. But here, Skype doesn't allow more than 25 participants. So we are restricting to only one group. So today's topic is reincarnation. So we'll, so from now onward, because you all have some basic understanding, so we will have more of an interactive session so that you all will be engaged. So I just yesterday I got one bad news that two of our members who are joining this group, so their uncle has expired because of cancer. So they were thinking that anyways, it's good for him because he was suffering from past 1.5 years, because you all know that cancer, in cancer, whenever person go through chemotherapy or other other medical, basically medications and all, and then that is a very suffering stage. So he was suffering a lot. So all his family members are feeling happy for him that at least he has relieved of all the suffering. So just wanted to know from all of you, so that now, because his body has ended, that so that means that, so just wanted to understand, what is your views on this, that his body has ended, so he's relieved of all the suffering, or do you think that he's still suffering? What all is your views on this? Shabnam Prabhu? Anyone can answer. Yeah, I can hear you. Yes. Tell me, Prabhu. You have muted it again. You unmuted. Yes. Okay. Now you speak.
Yeah. So I think, to be exact, we don't know. Because unless somebody has spiritually progressed and in pure consciousness, attains the supreme abode, he has to take another body. Right, but one thing is, like, if it was in this life, if he has to finish that karma, he would have at least whatever karma he is left for this life, he would have at least you know, finished that karma, and whatever karma left over is he has to you know, that person has to suffer in the next life.
Yes, and basically all the family member, they are saying that they have, that uncle has gone, so, but his body is still there. So actually, who has gone? Because his body, whatever, everything is there, so, but still the family member is saying that uncle has gone. So actually, who has gone?
The soul. The soul has gone.
Yeah. So actually, that is a good part there. Being born in India, that everyone understand that we are different from this body. Even though we say that this is our hand, this is our leg, but this I is something different. That I is soul, which remains and which is actually changing the body. So now today's topic is also on reincarnation, that how we are undergoing different changes, and we think that actually we are getting old, or we are getting diseased, but actually this is all bodily symptoms. So you all can mute yourself now, so that I can speak without much disturbance. Yeah. So today's topic is on reincarnation only. So anyways, because his uncle has departed, we should first one time chant Hare Krishna mantra for the departed soul, so that whatever destination he is going to get, Lord will give more mercy to him, and he will get some more pious karmas because of our chanting. So let's one time chant this Hare Krishna Maha Mantra for his spiritual progress. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So today's topic is reincarnation, Srila Prabhupada. So there is a discussion between Srila Prabhupada and one Western devotee. Or I'm not sure whether he's a devotee or he's an a reporter. So there was a conversation that was recorded, and we will be discussing on that. let me know if it is visible to you. Otherwise, once I will be speaking, then it will become more clear to you. So the part of conversation is presented here, where Srila Prabhupada is saying that one must first understand that he is a soul or something other than this, his body. So Mike Robinson is asking that when will he understand, we understand that. So Srila Prabhupada is explaining that you can understand this at any moment, but it requires a little intelligence. For example, as a child grows, he becomes a boy. The boy becomes a young man. The young man becomes an adult, and the adult becomes an old man. Throughout all this time, although his body is changing from child to an old man, he still feels himself to be the same person with the same identity. Just see, the body is changing, but the occupier of the body, the soul, is remaining the same. So we should logically conclude that when our present body dies, we get another body. This is called transmigration of the soul. So we all understand that, okay, we don't have any control that what kind of body we are getting. When we take birth, we don't know even that whether we are in a male body, we are in a female body. When we develop some consciousness, somewhat, maybe 5-6 years old, then someone will tell you that, okay, or 4-5 years old, then someone will tell you, oh, you are a boy, she is a girl and all. And then you actually identify that, okay, I'm having a body, male body, someone is having female body. And then basically you understand that, okay, this is what is your identity in terms of gender only. So then you are involved into some or the other activities. Initially you were studying, then basically different phases of studies, playing, everything. Whatever you are doing, you get an impression of it. Even right now, you can think that, okay, what, when I was 12-year-old, this is all the plays that I was playing. This is how I was enjoying. This is all the song that I was listening to. Everything you remember. But when you go in front of mirror, you find that your body is changed. Maybe your body has aged. At that point of time, you were in a very young body. You were looking very handsome, anything. And right now you find that, okay, somewhat wrinkle is coming, some white hairs are coming, gray hairing. So then you see that still I have the clear remembrance of what all I have done, but I can see that my body is somewhat changing. Now the body is not that youthful. Maybe the body is not that much energetic, but as a feeling level, as a soul level, I don't feel there is any changes. So that's why we find that even though the body, an old person, he also has similar feelings. Everything is same, but only his body is not that much fit now that he can do all the plays that he was doing earlier. So maybe even if we'll go to some athlete who was giving 2 to 4 hours daily in his gymming and all, but later when he will become old, then he may not be able to do that much amount of weight lifting or anything because his body has become old. But his, as a soul perspective, he is still the same person. So we can understand that this body, we have no control on it, but we got some body at our birth. And then we don't have any control on it, how it is getting old. So actually, whenever someone will, some spiritual person will go in some discourse and then he will ask that, okay, what is your problem? If he will ask, then basically 60-70% people will just raise one question that, Prabhuji, I am having problem that I am getting old, I am getting disease, please free me from this problem. So everyone is thinking, having this problem, oh, I am getting old, I am getting bald. If this can be just solved, that, okay, this old age can be solved, then I will be completely satisfied. So the real thing is that we should understand that actually we are different from this body. So right now people are spending too much of money just to maintain their body. They were going through so much of cosmetic surgery just to maintain, just to look somewhat younger. But they should understand that how much effort they can put. But then also, as the time will progress, this old age, disease and death, this is common. So this birth, old age, disease and death, till the point we are having this material body, till that point of time, we will need to undergo these all things, because this is law of material nature, which no one can change, how much effort he can put into this. So the scientists, they were trying this from last 200-300 years. They were saying that maybe soon we will get some or the other way by which we can stop it. So they are cheating some rich people, saying that, okay, you give us this much amount and then we will preserve your body in maybe in some nitrogen or something, some in cold atmosphere with some chemicals, we'll preserve your body. And once we will invent something that, okay, we can make some person who has died, we can make him again alive, then we'll make you alive. But this is all cheating that is going on. That person don't know that as soon as he will die, his body start decaying. Or even though if someone will maintain that particular body, but then also that soul has anyways transmigrated to some other body. So we don't have any control on it. Actually, we have control, but we can understand that when we get this body, then we have not decided that, okay, this will be our father, this will be our mother, I will take birth in this particular family. If we will be having this deciding power, then everyone would be born in a rich family. He should have got very beautiful body. So everyone will have achieved whatever they have desired. But without our own understanding, we are getting our body. We don't know whether we are we have not decided whether we'll get male body or female body, but we are getting by some superior order, which is called law of nature. So actually, we can understand that the body that we are getting is the sum result of our desires that we have in our past lives. So if we have got some human body, then we should understand that, okay, some or the other desires that might be there in us, maybe some pious activities also we have performed, that's why we have got human form of life. Some or the other pious activities one must have performed to get this human form of life, because this human form of life is very rare. Otherwise, anyone can get some animal body as well as per his desires. And if someone is in animal body, then after 84 lakh species. So if you are not utilizing this human body, then again you will be sent in this cycle where you have to transmigrate into 84 lakh species of life. And then automatically after transmigrating from 84 lakh species, taking birth as each and every animal or plant or whatever species you know that exist in this entire creation, then you will again get this human body. So this 84 lakh species actually is not only meaning that you will get body in this material world. So when we say 84 lakh species, then some people may think that, okay, maybe that many species may not be existing in Earth. But we are not only talking about Earth. When scriptures are talking, when the Vedas are talking, they are talking about the entire material creation. So even the human body has some categorization. So even in human body, we can get a human body which is like a civilized person, or we can get a human body of some aborigines, like which are near to some monkeys only. They are not at all civilized. Or we can get a human body even of an demigod. So even there are categorization in human body as well. But like we discussed in the last class, that getting human body in this material world is even more fortunate. Someone is more fortunate to get a human body in this earth rather than in a higher planetary system or to become demigod, because even demigod envied human being, because human being has very small lifespan. So as per even now, Einstein has also proved this theory of relativity, which was earlier given in our scriptures. That is in Srimad Bhagavatam, there was a mention of Brahma Vimochan Leela, where Brahma, he took all the friends of Krishna for few seconds, for few seconds, and within a few seconds, because Brahmalok is so much far that in this earth, 1 year has passed. So there was a complete story on Srimad Bhagavatam. So that means, so in Srimad Bhagavatam, it is explained then that time is relative. So that is, this theory of relativity is not new. It is already given in our scripture, even though Einstein has now proved it, that if someone is there in some higher planetary system, and he will return to this lower planetary system, then maybe he has spent 10 years there, but here 20 years are passed. Something like that Einstein has already given, and everyone agreed scientifically as well. So spiritually as well, it is already given in a scripture that in higher planetary system, their time span and the time span in Earth are different. So from the calculations of demigod, human beings live only for 40 days. So you can understand, we find many of the insects who are living only for 40 days. So for demigods, our lifespan is just like 40 days, just like a bug, just like an insect. So, but they are very happy for us, because if as per their calculation, this 40 days, if we can utilize in developing our God consciousness, then within this 40 days, we can go back home, back to Godhead. So for us, like, we think that anyways, this 80 years very long, but actually you can feel that this is not very long. 35, 40, 50 or 60 years are already crossed. We can see that it is just blinking of eye that we have spent all this lifetime. So remaining 10, 20 years will also cross like anything. So we should, if even we use this much time that is left. So when someone has asked Prabhupada that, Prabhupada, how much time it will be requiring for me to become Krishna conscious and to go back home, back to Godhead. So Prabhupada explained that it just need 1 second. So within 1 second, if you think that, okay, now I am surrendering to Krishna, now whatever time I have wasted, that is fine. But now whatever energy I am having, I will lead a holy life, Krishna conscious life. Or even if I will purely chant my Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, then I will be opening my door to go back home, back to Godhead. So from reincarnation perspective, you all can understand that this body is changing. Now we all understand that we are not this body. So Prabhupada, when he was explaining it in 1960s or something, so there was a lady who was sitting. She was very fat. She cannot even move properly. She was having many diseases. And when Prabhupada explained, actually, we are not this body, we are a spirit soul, then she became very happy. She told Prabhupada, I am very happy just to get this information that I am not this body, because I am suffering so much with this body. But as I understood that I am a spirit soul, now my all suffering has gone. So even if this particular thing you all can understand, then you can come out of most of the suffering. So now we are someone who is not having this understanding. They become very much frightened. Oh, now I am getting old. Soon I have to die. Anyways, like this illusion or this Maya, which is acting in this material world, is acting in such a fashion that everyone is thinking, no, I am not going to die. At least 10, 20 years are there. But we can understand the average human lifespan here is very less. And the mortality rate everywhere is 100%. So everyone has to die, even though someone may have to die within a year, someone may have to die after 5 years, after 10 years, but everyone has to die. So... So we cannot be happy just thinking that anyways, I have enough time to die. But we should think that, okay, whatever time we have now in our hand, how we can utilize it to actually go back home, back to Godhead, so that we do not have to transmigrate from one body to another body. So sometimes we become very fascinated. So we always watch all this Discovery channels, and where they are showing that all these animals, how peacefully they are living. So many people even think that, okay, even if I will get some animal body, what is the harm? I will be just enjoying the beauty of nature, and I will be just hovering around here and there in jungle. I anyways want to live near the trees and all, so I will get very peaceful life. But that is not the fact. If you will just when go to YouTube and just search for all these animals films that are being made, you will see that always after animal there are some or the other prey which is after him to catch him as a food. So if you will see some bird, then you will find some snake which is going around that bird, maybe eating that bird's egg or even eating that particular bird. Even if you will see some or the other animals, either lion is attacking, tiger is attacking, some way or the other they are because part of that food chain. So one should not falsely think that, okay, I will get some animal body and then I will be all peaceful. No, that is not the fact. Some or the other way, when the birds, they are not safe, eagle will go and they will catch him. And that is very dangerous, even because as a human form of life, we have made some society that, okay, you have some arrangement that no one will come on a street and just kill you just for food. So we should understand that whatever opportunity that we are getting, we should utilize. We should not think that maybe next birth I will become some animal and I will enjoy. No, animal are not enjoying. They are suffering a lot. You can go to your terrace, you may find some pigeon who has given laid some eggs and they are just protecting their eggs. And then whether it's cold or whether it's hot, they are just standing there. They have also made their family life. And they have become too attached with their family life, but they don't have intelligence. If someone will go and will ask them that, okay, you are not this body, you are this soul, they will not understand. But as a human being, we can understand. So we should not act like those animals and only who has made some nest and they are just thinking that they are all happy. So we are thinking we have intelligence. Even these birds are having intelligence. So these birds, some of the birds are so intelligent that they make their nest in such a fashion that there will be a tunnel to reach that particular nest so that none of the bigger bird can enter and can eat their eggs. Then they have inside as well, they will make all this swing so that they will be swinging in that nest. And because it will become dark, so they will catch all these fireflies, they will put inside their their nest so that the firefly will be blinking for 3-4 days and they are getting enough light. So they are also putting all their intelligence. They are also making their family. They are also very much attached to their family. They are daily going outside for some occupational duty, catching the food basically, and then bringing it back to the to their birds. So this eating, sleeping, mating, defending, everyone is doing. Eating, we are also eating, this animal is also eating. We can eat only little bit amount, but this elephant, you can see they can eat even 100 times more than the food that we are eating. And then also Lord is providing eating and sleeping. What we can sleep, polar bear and all, they can sleep so much compared to us. Mating, even if you see pigeons, they are mating 12 to 14 times in a day. So there is no match. And similarly in defending, even animal, whenever even a simple bird, if we want to catch that bird, she will fly away. So the sleeping, eating, mating, defending, even all the animals can do better than us. So only one thing that we can do better than the animals is that we can understand, we can get this knowledge that we are not this body, we are a spirit soul, and actually we can get a spiritual body. So this body is not a match for our spiritual soul. So because for soul, we understand that this soul cannot be burned, cannot be made wet, it cannot be killed in under any circumstances. So similarly, this body as well, if we can get some spiritual body, which is actually quite fit to enclose this spiritual soul, then we are all happy. So that spiritual body also we can get just by purely chanting this Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, just by getting this understanding. So I'll further move on with the passage. So then Mike Robinson is saying, so when body dies, it is just the physical bodies that dies, because in Western world, they don't understand, because that's why they are so much morose. They think that once their body will end, all their suffering will end. So that's why you can see right now the suicide rate is so high in the Western world, because Western world, they are thinking that we are just this body, we have to enjoy. That's why in Western world, even they are not doing marriages and all, because they think that marriage is something like taking responsibility. Then even they are not taking any responsibility of their parents as well, because they are thinking, oh, we just got this life just to enjoy, so let me enjoy this life. Because even in Bible, there was evidences that, okay, we have this reincarnation, but somehow or the other, just to focus people, they have altered the Bible in such a way, saying that we have only this life, so you act piously. So actually they wanted to say, some of the people who have altered this Bible, they actually want to stress on this particular thing that, okay, you got this human body, you utilize it fully and you go back to God. But people are so atheistic that they understood it in such a fashion that, okay, we have only this lifetime to enjoy, so let us enjoy. So they have killed the purpose. So they are thinking, whatever we can do, we can just try to enjoy. So that's why so much of material advancement they have done. They have opened all these casinos, all this sport bar, everything, because they are just thinking we have this lifetime and we can enjoy, and then we don't know where we will go. So anyways, we are going to vanish. This body will end, we will end. But actually that is not fact. That's why many people, they are not doing anything. They are not leading a responsible life. And sometime if they will think that, okay, they are getting more and more suffering, then they take some suicide pill and they just die. So many percentage of people are committing suicide just thinking that by ending this body, they are getting, they are done with the suffering that they are undergoing. But actually, we should understand that this suicide is very much dangerous. Why? Because if this human body you have not utilized fully in the way it is given, so if you have not utilized, then you have ended it before its a certain time span. That is, I may have to live for 80 years, but I committed suicide thinking, oh, this is very painful life, I must commit suicide. I committed suicide in, let's suppose, 35 years. So then remaining years, whatever I am having, that is 25 years, then that remaining years, 25 years, I have to spend my life as a ghost. So that is a very dangerous condition. Why? Because ghost has this soul, that is, soul is there. Then they have this false ego, intelligence, and this mind. So these three things always remain with soul, and they decide that what next body they are going to get. This mind, false ego, and intelligence. These three things remain with that person. And but the body is not there, but because the mind is there, intelligence, false ego is there. So all the desires are there. So when a person becomes ghost, even though he has a desire to eat some food stuff, but he cannot eat. That's why these ghosts and all, they possess some person. They possess means they actually, their false ego, mind and intelligence, they attach themselves to some other body who is somewhat weaker sometimes, or who is not clean in his habit. So you'll find that many people who are addicted to drinking or intoxication, they are actually possessed by all these ghosts, because then their mind and intelligence anyways become very weak. So it will become very easy for any ghost to attach themselves with that their particular body. And why they attach is just to get the pleasure of this eating and whatever food stuff that they want to eat, or whatever sense gratification that they want to do. Even though right now scientists think that, okay, all this thing is anyways nonsense. There is nothing called ghost, or like we do pindadan whenever some soul depart, then we do pindadan. That is, we offer some food stuff with some authorized mantras that we chant. So why this all is done? Because first, there are chances that many of our ancestors, because they might not have lived a very pious life, they may just get ghostly body. So the ghostly body we get in two circumstances. One is when someone commits suicide, that is for sure 100% he will get ghostly body. Second is whenever someone dies who has not lived his life very piously. If someone has lived his life in a sinful fashion, then Lord will not allow, that is this material nature even will not allow to provide him or her with a new material body. So they will have to undergo suffering by getting a body of not getting a body. So they may be living a ghostly life. So that's why this pindadan is performed, which is authorized, which is a food stuff which is sanctified by all the mantras, so that they can get a preta body. Preta body is just like a thumb, is a body which is equal to the thumb. So this kind of body that they will get, so that they will not suffer more, and in their journey which is toward hell, they will not suffer more and more. So this is all actually scientific, but nowadays people, they understand that, okay, we are just eating with our hand, with our body and all. So how can something which is not having any body can eat? But that is all true. And that's why earlier we used to perform all this pindadan. People used to go to Gaya and they perform pinda offering. Because when pinda offering is done, I have anyway shared one video on that as well earlier. I may share it again. So when this pindadan offering is done for 13 days, because the soul, when he leave his body, then for 13 days actually he is hovering around in that particular place only where he has died, or to the person he is more and more attached. So that's why, like, one used to perform more and more pinda offering and all, or this offering the food stuff to brahmanas, because even the soul can eat via the brahmanas. Nowadays, even we don't find qualified brahmanas, but yeah, we can invite some person who are qualified. If we understand that, okay, this particular brahmana, he is not having any attachment with wealth and all, which you may find many in ISKCON. So you can invite them and offer them food which is offered to Lord. If they are eating, then actually the soul, they can also get the nourishment by that, and they will be free from that ghostly body. Or similarly, the pindadan and all, this is done for 13 days so that there will be food that is provided to that soul as well. And then there are messengers of Yamduta, basically Yamraj, which is called Yamdutas, those who are coming actually to take that particular soul. And there is a journey, very long journey that they have to cover again to the Yamloka, which is basically lower planetary system. So meanwhile, if someone is not offering any pindadan, then the Yamdutas, because they also have not very advanced intelligence, they will start torturing that particular soul more and more. Because of their anger, they may be giving more and more lashes to that particular soul, and they are giving him some particular, so actually they will feel that as well, even though we might be thinking that how then when the person has died then they will feel, but they will be given that kind of body where they can endure more and more torture. So whatever sinful activities that they have done, their body will be made such that they will be able to sustain all those all those punishment that will be implicated upon them. So for 13 days, actually soul remain within within the person with whom he is more attached. If someone is carrying this their body, that's why we are calling Ram Nam Satya. Why we are speaking the names of Lord? So actually the scientific reason behind it is that the soul was also actually hovering around, or actually is taking part in the procession that we are taking of that dead body. So that's why we are taking names of Ram, so that he will get more and more spiritual pious credits, and with that he can progress towards some better destination, not some hellish destination. And that's why we have this concept of actually burning this body, or basically first we are doing burning of this body because sometimes soul is so much attached to his body. So you will find even the old people, when you will ask them whether you want to die, they will say, no, I don't want to die, because they are very much attached to this body. So that's why we need to burn this body, so that the final attachment that they have with this body will diminish. They will understand, oh, now this body is gone, I cannot occupy it anymore, and they will go away. If someone will not actually properly cremate that body, or will not properly burn that body, so sometime in Western country they will throw away all these bodies and all, then there are chances that the soul will again try to enter into that particular body and become more and more ghostly being. So to avoid that, like we burn it so that their final attachment will be gone and they can progress. And then we perform so many of the rituals. Actually, everyone has to perform these rituals. They are scientific in fashion. In Garuda Puran, it is given, and each and every details are given. Now people are not having that much time, or they don't have actually that much faith that they can understand. But in Garuda Puran, each and every detail that how this their soul is progressing toward next path is all explained. If someone has time, they can go through Garuda Puran, they can understand each and everything. It is explained completely in a scientific fashion. So when people die, it is just the physical bodies that die. Yes, that is explained very elaborately in Bhagavad Gita. Na jayate mriyate va kadachin na hanyate hanyamane sharire. So this is explained in Bhagavad Gita. In verse 2.20, you should all have Bhagavad Gita, you should all try to read it. Maybe next time in next class, I will ask you that whether you have gone through this Bhagavad Gita verse 2.20 and what is your understanding. Because if you will not read it, you will not develop some bit of this reading habit, then definitely you are wasting this human form of life. Why? Because you are not understanding each and every spiritual science behind all this soul, then you, whatever you are doing is time waste. So just try to read Bhagavad Gita at least one passage every day, or at least in a week try to read it, so that you will get more and more scientific understanding. Because we should, I don't want that you all become just sentimentalist. You won't be able to defend everything in a scientific fashion. When Prabhupada was there, or some of his disciples who are great scientists, they actually can defend each and everything. So our Shastras has given scientific explanation behind each and every phenomena. So if you will have some time you will spend in reading, then even you can also defend, at least you can defend yourself that, okay, whatever I am following is actually scientifically correct. So this all understanding you should try to have. So Mike Robinson is saying, can you explain to me a bit more, if the soul is undying, does everybody's soul go to be with God when they die? So this is all we think, that okay, now this body is gone, so so we can see this fly always coming. So this fly also, because she's in some body, so she's trying to get some food and all. So whatever we are doing, she's also wasting her time in getting some food or something, but she's not at fault, because if some spiritual knowledge is given, then she cannot get it. But that's why we recommend loud chanting of this Hare Krishna Mahamantra, because even the insects or the birds, those who will hear this Hare Krishna Mahamantra, because they cannot commit more offenses against the holy name, or because they are bound up so much by this material laws, if we are loudly chanting this Hare Krishna Mahamantra, then even they will be purified. At least next human birth is guaranteed. So many of us who has got this human birth, we can understand. We may be animal in last life. Someone may have thrown away some of the prasadam and we have eaten it. We may be having some dog body, we have eaten that prasadam and we got this human form of life. We may be some bird or insect and someone may be chanting and we heard it, and that's why we got this human form of life. So this human form, that's why this loud chanting one must perform. That is loudly chant this Hare Krishna mantra, so that even the trees who are there in this tree's body for some 5,000 years as well, they may get at least get the next human form of life. These birds, insect, everyone can get at least human form of life, which will be opportunity for them to go back home, back to water. That's why we discourage anyone to eat non-vegetarian food stuff and all, because you don't know your ancestors, maybe because of their in their life they might have eaten so much of non-vegetarian food stuff that they have to undergo. By laws of nature, they also have to become chicken or they have to become fish. And when you are eating them, then actually you, even though you are feeling very much grateful to your grandfather, great grandfather, but actually you are finishing this body and you are eating them. So you should get this understanding. That's why we should not eat non-vegetarian food. Lord is for Lord, each and everyone, whether it's he's a human being or whether he's an animal, he's a lower animal, whatever, they all are same. Actually, we only, if we will not be able to utilize this body, then we have to take some other body. We may take some body of some chicken or some fish as well. If you can understand how much pain we have to undergo, how much suffering we have to undergo if someone cut us and will eat us. Because then again, whatever time span is destined, for example, for chicken, a time span is destined by Lord that, okay, the chicken will live in this particular body for, let's suppose, 100 days. And if we are killing that particular chicken in 10 days, then again, he has to take again birth in that particular chicken body for again 90 days. Then again, we cut it in 10 days, then again for 80 days. So same, if we are enduring so much pain to that particular jiva by eating that particular body, then we can understand how much great sin we are committing. Then definitely we have to suffer as well. So someone, that's why we are saying that to chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra, one should avoid four sinful activities: intoxication, illicit sex, meat eating and gambling. So this meat eating also, if we are devouring someone with their body, then we also have to undergo suffering. And when there will be suffering, then sinful life, then we cannot actually properly chant this Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So this spiritual life and Krishna consciousness and sinful life cannot go together. One should understand this. One cannot remain sinful and he can think that he can perform Krishna consciousness. No, that is not possible. One should stop his sins, because many people say that, okay, I want to go, why God is so cruel, why he is giving so much suffering to us. But we should see that with our own action, how much suffering we are giving to other souls. So Lord is even so much merciful that still he has given us this human form of life. He is not taking that away. Otherwise, if there will be law of karma such that the moment you are taking someone's life or you are just eating some non-vegetarian food stuff, at that point of time your human birth is gone, then you have lost this opportunity. You must have. Every one of us has lost this opportunity. But Lord is so merciful that he is giving us suffering only, without taking our life, so that at least with this suffering, we can get some higher understanding and we can go back home, back to water. But without becoming pure, many people, they come, they will say, oh, just show me God and then I will become Krishna conscious. No, if we are giving you this Hare Krishna Mahamantra, if someone can purely chant this Hare Krishna Mahamantra, then also they will realize each and everything. But they just have to listen this Hare Krishna Mahamantra by putting proper faith. Then actually they will become qualified to actually see Krishna, but they don't have this time. They think that I will lead completely sinful life, you just show me God. But God is not someone's order supplier that I want to see him and he will be just on my command, he's ready to just show himself to me. He also need to see that whether we are qualified or not. And when we are getting all this message, many people, they are not even coming at all. So we are not even ready to give our 1 hour to this to understand what is God. Then definitely how we can expect that God can be visible to our eyes? If we are not doing any tapasya, any pain we are not taking, we are not taking any pain to even wake up and attend the sessions which are authorized by Lord in his disciplic succession, then how can we think that we become very fortunate to actually see the Lord? No, that is not possible. So if he does not defy himself, so many people think that, okay, when someone has died, they have gone to Vaikuntha. So we said that, okay, now he has gone to Swarg, or we think unko moksh mil gaya, he's got liberation. No, that is not fact, actually. No one after leaving this body can will get, no one means 99.99% don't get liberation or they will go back home back to it. No. Very rare who live their life, this particular life in that fashion, where they can actually get this liberation. And to even go to Swarg Loka, even right now, I think 99% are not even going to Swarg Loka because of so much sinful action that they are performing because of the influence of Kali Yuga. 99.99% people are going to hellish planet. But we should not try to become that 99.99%. At least we should try to chant so that at least either we'll get human body or some better body, but we'll not get worst body. So at least this much good that we all can do to ourselves. So if he does not qualify himself, then he gets another material body, and there are 84 lakh different bodily form. According to his desire and karma, the laws of nature give him a suitable body. It is just like when a man contracts some disease and then develop that disease. Suppose somebody has contracted smallpox, so after 7 days he developed the symptoms, which is called incubation. So whatever we are doing, actually we are developing that particular body. So if we are still involved in eating so much of non-vegetarian food stuff, we are not giving any good ear to all this teachings, and we are just involved into non-vegetarian food stuff eating, then actually we are developing ourselves to get some animal, maybe carnivorous animal body, because our desire is there. Oh, we want to eat non-vegetarian food stuff. So Lord will say, oh, right now with this human form of body, which is anyways herbivorous, because all our intestine system, all our teeth are more of an herbivorous, similar to herbivorous animal. So if Lord will see that, okay, anyways, you only desire to eat non-vegetarian food stuff. Right now, only 1% or 2% of non-vegetarian food stuff we can eat, because we need it to accompany it with some rice or some roti, which is more in quantity compared to this non-vegetarian food stuff. But the desire is there, so we get a completely carnivorous body. So we may get some body of animal or some lion, tiger, or some or the other carnivorous animal, where we will be completely sustaining ourselves in non-vegetarian food stuff. So that's why whatever activities we are doing, we should be very careful that what kind of body we are getting in our next life is actually dependent on whatever actions that we are doing right now. So similarly, during your life, you associate with various modes of material nature, and that association will decide what kind of body that you are going to get in your next life. So that is strictly under the laws of nature. Everyone is controlled by the laws of nature. They are completely dependent. But out of ignorance, people think that they are free. They are not free. They are imagining that they are free, but they are completely under the laws of nature. So your next birth will be decided according to your activities, sinful or pious, as the case may be. So that's why at least try to perform pious activities. And the most pious activities is actually to perform devotional services. And it is even beyond the pious activities, because by pious activities, we can at least go to some heavenly planet. But by performing devotional services to Lord, if we are purely doing it, devotional services, then we can go back home, back to Godhead, where we'll get a spiritual body, which is free from this old age, birth, disease and death. So even demigods, even like we were talking about demigods like Indra and so many demigods, they also get some body. And why they were envying human being? Because as per their calculation, human beings are living only for 40 days. So for 40 days, if we can utilize this, that is for us, it is anyways 80 years, we can utilize whatever time we spend, whatever is left with us in Krishna consciousness, then within this life, we will be free from all this cycle and we can go back home back to Godhead. But in demigod life, actually, there are so much of material enjoyment. People are drinking somrasa. So actually, somrasa is different from liquor. So someone is drinking liquor, they try to relate it with somrasa. That is false. Actually, somrasa is a drink which is available in heavenly planet. When someone is drinking it, then their sinful reactions are getting diminished. But this liquor that people think is called somrasa, no, that is not the fact. That liquor, if someone is drinking, then they will be implicit with more and more sinful reaction. Then they will have to suffer more and more. They have to go down. Okay, but the somrasa is somewhat different. So they can enjoy that somrasa. They are having so much heavenly opulences that they will forget about Krishna. Because even right now, you will see that if someone is very rich, Tata Birla, Ambanis and all, they are somewhat religious, but if someone will ask them, okay, you chant this Hare Krishna Mahamantra, they will say, no, no, I have no time, I have so many responsibilities, so many factories I have to run, so many things I have to look after. So you can understand, if someone can enjoy in richness, then anyways, if they are having, someone is having opulences, then anyways, they will forget about Krishna. So you can understand, all these demigods, even they are more beautiful, they have more long life, they have more and more opulences than compared to this person who are having opulence in this material world. So they are more opulent, so that's why it is more difficult for them to perform this Krishna consciousness. So that's why they envied this human being, because for us, we are getting somewhat amount of happiness, somewhat amount of distress. So, but we are somewhat balanced. We can perform this Krishna consciousness by getting some knowledge from all this suffering that we are undergoing, that okay, this material place is not a fit place to be, and we can try to go back home, back to Godhead. But if someone is very opulent, like people in this higher planetary system, then this understanding as well, they will forget. Because we can also understand, in all the weekends, whenever we have we have things to enjoy, we go for some picnic, we go to some park, we go to some movie theater, we go to some mall, because propensity to enjoy is there. And if we have money, we can spend, then we'll purchase this watch, that shoes. And this way, or in Amazon, we'll do some or the other shopping and we'll waste our complete life. But if someone is poor, he can understand anyways, he cannot enjoy more. And if he will get this knowledge, then he can actually embrace this particular knowledge and he can actually chant this Hare Krishna Mahamantra and he can go back home, back to Godhead. So that's why getting an opulent life is also not very conducive to Krishna consciousness. So the real education will become when someone will understand that you are not this body, you are a spirit soul. And because you are a spirit soul, you are changing your body. So this is actually the ABC of a spiritual understanding. So when your body is finished or annihilated, you are not finished. You get another body. Just as you may change your coat and shirt. If you come to see me tomorrow wearing a different shirt and a different coat, does that mean that you are a different person? No. Similarly, each time you die, you change your bodies. But you, the spirit soul within the body, remains the same. The point has to be understood. Then one can make further progress in the science of Krishna consciousness. So actually, when the child is in the womb, so at that point of time, he's having the full consciousness. Believe me, he's having the full consciousness. By the mercy of Lord, he can remember his past 100 lives. And then he can understand that how he has wasted his complete lifespan. And then actually he prays to Lord, oh Lord, this time if I will get human form of life, I will utilize it and I will go back home, back to Godhead. But once he is born, because of all this exhaustion, he is completely covered with the illusion. Actually, this is the way. He will become completely covered in illusion. But somehow or the other, by the mercy of Lord or his representatives, he will again get this understanding that how much you have suffered. So about reincarnation as well, you all must understand that we all have heard some or the other stories that someone has reincarnated or someone has this past life understanding. Past life remembrance. So I have very real example, actually, my own Tauji, which I will say, which is my elder brother of my father. So elder brother of my father, he was having past life remembrance. So he actually, when he was born, when he was young only, he told my grandmother that actually I was born to this and this family, this Muslim family I belong to. This was the name of my wife. She was living in this particular city. And I want to go back to my wife and my kids. All were there. So my grandmother became very fearful. Oh, this child, he's saying that, okay, that his wife is living in this particular city and this particular place. This is all the name of his kid. So my grandmother made some inquiries that, okay, whatever city actually he's telling, whatever the address that he is giving. So she made inquiries by his relative that you go in this place and you check whether this kind of lady is living, whether that lady is having this child, whether his husband has expired, things like that. So that relative went to that particular same spot and he checked, and then he came to know that the same lady, the name was same, all their kids, whatever he's explaining about his husband, same name was there. And my grandmother became very fearful, and then she avoided taking him to that particular place. And then slowly and slowly, he also got accustomed with this particular life that anyways, now I got this body. So slowly and slowly, this remembrance is gone. So actually, Lord sometime give this particular remembrance to some people just to just to give this evidence that okay, you are actually reincarnating. It is fact that you have got, you were having earlier body, earlier having some different body, and now you are having some different body, but the same soul is there. So you, sometime people will have their past birth remembrance. So not only we are saying this in Krishna consciousness, even Christians who now believe that we are not having reincarnation, they have done scientific studies and they understand that there are so many cases where people are reincarnating, that they have the complete full 100% remembrance of the past life. Even in newspapers as well, you will find that some kids, they will explain to their mother that this is how I lived, this is how I died, and now they are living, they have made some compromise that they are all living together under one shed, so their past birth parents or family members are also living together with the child. So that's why Lord understand that this will complicate more situation for people like us. If we remember our past life as well, then our life will be more complicated actually, because we have remembrance of our past life as well, so we cannot actually make relationship with this family as well. Even that family is living far, so it become more complicated. So that's why Lord is saying that I am giving you the forgetfulness and I am giving you the remembrance. So Lord, that's why at the time of birth, make us forget everything, whatever has happened in our past life, we completely forget it. And then we start living our life as a fresh, because whatever life we might have lived in our earlier birth as well, it's not making any difference. The only difference is making this knowledge that actually you all are existing from millions of years, millions of life that you have lived. Only this life, if you can just utilize in Krishna consciousness, then you can go back home, back to God. So actually this decision is with us only. So it is our own decision that whether we want to live in illusion or we want to live with Krishna. So why it is our own decision? Because if we can purely chant, then we will get the strength not to lead a sinful life. And with that strength, we can further progress in Krishna consciousness, or either we can enjoy whatever life we can have in this material world, or we can make some or the other thing, we can waste our lifespan. So it is all choices with us. So Lord is so compassionate, he is most compassionate father, that he is giving us all the opportunity that okay, I am giving you all this knowledge, I am distributing all this knowledge via my representatives. So he's sending all these spiritual masters who are coming from a spiritual planet, who are giving us the knowledge, and then other people like us also taking this knowledge and trying to propagate it. So Lord is trying to give this particular knowledge, but now it is our duty. So you can understand how fortunate you all are, how much pious activities you might have done that you are getting this knowledge. And if right of now as well you are not utilizing this knowledge and you are not progressing, you are not opening your path to back home, back to Godhead, then actually you are wasting your life. Then you can understand that how much problem you are inviting for yourself, because then again you will go into that 84 like species of life, which is not very good. So we should all try to think that how much important it is. And if someone will purely chant, they will purely get this understanding. So like I already explained, this is science. If you will purely listen to Hare Krishna Mahamantra, this Hare Krishna Mahamantra is non-different than Krishna himself. Then it will manifest automatically all this knowledge. You don't have to do some mental speculation or some thought process that you have to apply, nothing. Your heart will be completely purified by itself. And this is something that you all can practice yourself. You just chant and you will realize itself. Whatever you are thinking, you are being attached with this bodily platform of life, you automatically get this understanding that how much people are suffering, how much I was suffering, just considering I myself as this body. So even though we all have this, technically we have all, because being born in India, we have this knowledge. We are not this body, we are this soul. We are not this body, we are this soul. But we are just saying it like a parrot. If we actually understand it, then each and every moment that we are living, we will live according to that. We are not this body, we are soul, and that soul can get a spiritual body, we can go back home, back to Godhead. So choice is yours. We cannot force someone that okay, because of him I have lost my this chance, because he made me angry and that's why I lost my this chance, or he made me go into ignorance. No, this is all your independent choice, your personal choice. If you are properly chanting, if you are purely chanting, then you can come above to that particular stage. And it will not happen that okay, because I am not becoming spiritual, because people who are becoming spiritual, they leave their family and all. No, they become more attached. So many of you who are attending this session are actually my own family member. Many of you who are attending the session are my own friend. So it is not that I have abandoned you all and I have gone to some Himalayas. No, I have my love for you all has become increased more and more, and that's why I want that you all get this knowledge and you actually get the highest thing, that is you can go back home, back to Godhead. If I just think on mental level that I will whenever I will meet you, I will take you some mall, I will take you some pub or club, then that is not real love. This is real love, that I am trying to give you the real knowledge so that you can actually get out of this cycle, you can get out of this suffering for one and all. So we should not think that if I will become spiritual, then my love for you all will decrease. It will increase more and we'll get proper understanding. We can actually do good for others, because Prabhupada used to say, people say that why to do Krishna consciousness? We can do good to other. But to do good to other, you should understand what is good. And to understand what is good, you should actually use this method. That is, you should be Krishna conscious. Then you can actually understand that what is good for other. One may be doing good by feeding non-vegetarian food stuff to all the orphan people. Or maybe in old age home, he is providing all the non-vegetarian food stuff. He is thinking that he is doing good. He is giving all the food items to those person. But he is actually doing bad. Why? Because he is impliciting them in more and more negative reactions. So he is not doing good. So that's why to do good as well, we should understand what is good. And that understanding we can only get by chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So this process is very subtle. The spirit soul is invisible to our material eyes. It is atomic in size. After the destruction, the destruction of God's body, which is made up of senses, bone, blood, bone, fat, and so forth, the subtle body of mind, intelligence, and egos goes on working. So we can understand our body is made up of bone, fat, blood. Even we don't have any control on us. If the bone of our finger will increase more than the skin, then it will come out. But Lord has made all the arrangement, the genes, the coding is there in us that, okay, this bone will not grow more than whatever the covering of our finger is. So everything is, when we are eating our food, it is automatically digested. We don't have to study physics, chemistry to make it digested. No, by the laws of nature, the body that Lord has given, everything is happening on his own. But we should understand this body is different than us. We should not get illusioned by this, just the outer beauty of it. Because even the beauty is not skin deep. All this perspiration, everything is even coming out of our skin. So we can understand that it is completely made up of blood, bone, fat, all the useless stuff. So we should not get very much attached to this body. We should be attached to soul. And we should be attached to everyone on the level of soul platform. And then we should try to see that what good we can do for them. Not only on the bodily platform that, okay, anyways, I can take that person to the parlor and they will do some threading or some massage and everything. And then he will be all right. No, this is all on the bodily level. Or I may make him eat some nice food stuff. I will take him to CCD or Pizza Hut or some restaurant and then they will be happy. No, if you are really concerned, you can make prasad for him. That is food which is not made without onion, garlic. You offer it to the Lord and then you can feed that particular person. So he will get more pious credit. He will get purified. Not by eating in KFC, all this non-vegetarian food stuff. He will get more and more sins. So the subtle body of mind, intelligence and ego goes on working. So this subtle body that we are having, so beyond this body, we have a subtle body, which is made up of soul, mind, intelligence and ego. And also we have subtle eyes as well. So sometimes people are having this out of body experience. So we nowadays, people are thinking this in scientific community, that many people who are undergoing operation in operation theater, who are very critical, sometime they come out of that body and they're hovering over. And they can see that their operation is being performed on this body, whatever scissor people are using, whatever doctors are talking. So they get this out of body experience because this mind, this soul, mind, intelligence, ego has eyes as well by which it can see. So people, when they are dying, actually they hover over. So they are on the top, they can see whatever is going on with their body. Even the body is being burned, they can see because they also have this particular subtle body. Okay, so this subtle body, then as per the work that they are performing, they will get another kind of body. So by Lord arrangement only, when we leave this particular body, so if we have lived a very sinful life, or we become, for example, we become very attached to our dog. We become very attached to our dog that at the time of our death, we are just thinking of dog. Then Lord will allow that, okay, you anyways want to love dog, so I am giving you the full propensity. So it will to the or subtle body will automatically go to the womb of some dog and we'll take a dog body, and then we will be satisfying our this propensity to love dog in fullest. So then we will be living with the same body of dog, we are having a dog family, and we will get this, we'll be losing this consciousness that okay, earlier we were human body and now we have dog body. So all the consciousness will be lost, so we will be forgetting about everything, and then we are enjoying like dogs only. So that's why whatever thoughts that we are having is dependent on the actions that we are taking in this lifetime. So we have to be very careful that what action we are taking in this lifetime, what attachment that we are developing in this lifetime. So earlier people were married, like last time I discussed, so men were always trained to become a pure Vaishnava in earlier days in our Vedic age. Why they were trained to become a pure Vaishnava? So that when they will die, they are attached to Krishna, they will go back home, back to Godhead. When their spouses are dying, they are becoming more and more attached to their husband only, because throughout their life, they are thinking about their husband. So at the death as well, they are thinking about their husband. And because husband has gone to the spiritual planet, they will also go to a spiritual planet. Child, even though he's attached to their father, a father was a pure devotee of Lord, he was thinking, child was thinking about his father at the time of death, child will also go back home, back to Godhead. So that's why this is how our Vedic system was running. But now we have spoiled everything. Now the husband is also going into hell. Then similarly, if wife is thinking about husband, then she also have to go to hell. So that's why we are not saying you become attached to even your family member. You try to become attached to Krishna, because we don't know what will be the destination of our family member. So so at the time of death, this subtle body carries the small spirit soul to the gross body. The process is just like air carrying a fragrance. So sometimes when we smell some rose, or when there is a rose garden, then we are getting some fragrance. So that fragrance we cannot see that, okay, but we can understand, oh, somewhere there is a rose garden and then fragrance is coming. So we cannot see this fragrance, but we can actually get some understanding of it. So similarly, our subtle body or this soul is so minute in size. In scripture, it is given that our tip of hair, that is tip of hair, this round part, if you divide into 10,000 parts, then what is the dimension of one part is actually the dimension of spirit soul. So this spirit soul is carried just like air carrying fragrance, and it will go to some other body. So nobody can see where the rose fragrance is coming from, but we know that it is being carried by air. You cannot see how, but it is being done. Similarly, the process of transmigration of soul is very subtle. According to condition of mind at the death, the minute spirit soul enter into the womb of a particular mother through the semen of a father, and the soul develop a particular type of body given by the mother. It may be a human being, it may be a cat, a dog, or anything. So actually we might be thinking, oh, just because of the action and reaction of the semen and ova, actually one child is coming. No, that is not the fact. Actually, someone, Lord has, because of the person's karma, they will be allocated one father body. And then this soul will be there in that particular father's body. And then with the semen, it will pass to the mother's womb and it will mix with the ova, and then a child is formed. So it is not that we think that, okay, it's anyways by some or the other mechanism that we are. So actually this soul need to be there. Then only someone will have fertilization, or then only the child will come out. So now we can understand that now the situation is so dangerous that even mother are killing their own child. So in the womb only, with all this medicines now available, they are killing their own child in a womb itself. So many abortions that we are going on. So we cannot even have this liberty to say that, okay, maybe in this lifetime I will not do my Krishna consciousness. Maybe in next human life I will get, then I will do Krishna consciousness. No. Even right now you can understand mother are killing their child on the womb. So even though you might be, by the Lord's arrangement, you will be allocated some human body. But then also the mother, these days are so cruel, they may go for some abortion and you will be killed in the womb. And then again, you will be born as some animal or something. So you should not wait for your next body and then to become Krishna conscious. Try to become Krishna conscious in this lifespan. So the soul develop a particular type of body given by mother. It may be human being, it may be cat, a dog, or anything. So the way you, when you came into existence, you don't know whether you are a child, whether you are a boy, you are a girl, you are a human being, or what. Similarly, when you will be born as a cat or dog, you will not get any understanding. Slowly and slowly, as you will become somewhat mature, then you understand, oh, I am dog, I should do like this. Oh, I am a cat, I should run after some milk. So then you will get some understanding of food anyways, I have to get somehow or the other. So then you will start working by basic instinct, but you should not try to think that maybe next birth we'll do this thing. We should try to do it in this lifetime as well. So Mike Robinson is asking, is a very valid question. So are you saying that we have to do something else before this life? Srila Prabhupada is saying yes. And we keep coming back as something else as the next time. Yes, because you are eternal. According to your work, you are simply changing bodies. So like we can understand, when I was going to office, I'm wearing shirt, pant. Right now I'm wearing dhoti kurta. So maybe I'm changing this dress, but I am the same person. It is not that I am changed as a person. So similarly, even the body is changing, but the soul remains same, the same understanding that we are having right now, whatever the way we are thinking right now. Similarly, we will also think if we'll get some other human body. If animal body will get, then it is so much of covered. So maybe in later sessions, we'll discuss how much covering it is. Covering of illusion is there in animal body and human body. So actually, the same kind of understanding will be there, but we will be with some different body. And if we will become just attached to this body, oh, now I got some very handsome body. Now I just become some model, some actor, and just I become someone very famous, then we are wasting our life. So because we are eternal, according to your work, you are simply changing bodies. Therefore, you should want to know how to stop this business. How you can remain in your original spiritual body, that is called Krishna consciousness. So Mike Robinson is saying, so if I become Krishna conscious, I wouldn't risk coming back as dog. Srila Prabhupada is saying no. So he's quoting one text. Jan karam chame divyam evam yo veti tatvatah tyakta deham punar janmam naiti mam eti so Arjuna. So this is a very important verse in Bhagavad Gita 4.9. One who knows the transcendental nature of my appearance and activities does not upon leaving the body take his birth again in this material world, but attain my spiritual abode, Arjuna. So this is very important. Why Lord is coming again and again? All this Mahabharata and Ramayana, we are getting very attached to it. We are thinking, oh, I am like Karna only. I am getting all the injustice. I am very much attached. But I am getting all the injustice. I am like Karna. Someone is thinking I am like Arjuna. Someone who is interested in politics, they are more attached to a Shakuni character. He is very good. So some way or the other, people are attached to. Someone is voracious eater. He's thinking himself comparable to Bhima. So people are getting attached. So many activities. Lord is setting up all this stage. And then he's with all these stories, he's putting this message of Bhagavad Gita. And one who can understand that why Lord is making so many people take birth in this material world just to play his pastime so that people get attracted, because we are so fools, we are attracted to something we want to hear, someone we want to, something we want to see, some drama we want to see. So he has given all these stories, and in between all this Mahabharata story, which is the actual pastimes, it is not mythology. Mythology is the wrong term. It is the actual pastimes that are being performed by his devotees. So all these Pandavas and all, they are actually from a spiritual world. They all came just to perform this pastime so that people become attached to their pastime, and then they get this message of Bhagavad Gita, and then they understand, and then they can make some inquiry to go back home, back to Godhead. But nowadays people are so corrupt that Mahabharata, Ramayana, whatever they are making, they are just adulterating it just to get some or the other TRP rating. So there will be no message of Bhagavad Gita. Only Krishna is playing like someone like us only, and he's just doing some or the other. He's just playing jokingly with Radha and all. So they are not giving the actual message, and because they themselves are not having actual message. So that's why all this scripture, we should listen from some authorized source. Otherwise, the meanings are lost. So nowadays, even though we are watching all this Ramayana, Mahabharata, but we are not getting any knowledge, because people who are giving this knowledge, they are after money. They are just after some TRP rating, whatever serials they are making. Even though they don't have real understanding, they are not giving the real understanding. And one who is after sense gratification, one who is after money only, Lord will also not give them this intelligence. Because he understands that anyways, like we say, until unless we are not purified, Lord is not revealed to us. So similarly, they cannot give this knowledge to us. But it is there in Bhagavad Gita. That's why Prabhupada, when he came, there were 500, 600 varieties of Bhagavad Gita. But he gave this Bhagavad Gita as it is. Because whatever Krishna is speaking is all fact. People have adulterated it. Even so-called many spiritual leaders, they said, no, there is no one called Krishna. These five Pandavas are actually five sense organs. Something or the other, they just adulterated it. because they are not devotees of Lord. But anyone who is pure devotee of Lord, they can understand the message as it is. That's why Srila Prabhupada has given the message as it is in Bhagavad Gita, that one who knows the transcendental nature of my appearance by Lord, even though he don't have any activity to do, he is coming again and again as a Krishna, as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in every ages he is coming just to deliver us, that don't waste our human life. You should all come back home, back to Godhead. So God is saying, anyone who understands me is free from birth and death. So if you'll get this understanding why Krishna is coming, you get attached to pastimes of Krishna, you are free from birth and death. But one cannot understand God by materialistic speculation. That is not possible. If some will think, no, God, why to surrender to Krishna? I can surrender to something else. Then with mental speculation, that is not possible. One must first come to the spiritual platform. Then he gets the intelligence required to understand God. And when he understands God, he does not get any more material bodies. He goes back home, back to Godhead. He lives eternally. No more change of body. So we should all understand that. That's why it is so much importance is given to understand this Krishna consciousness, so that you can all go back home, back to Godhead. You should not just remain here. You understand Krishna. He has given so many books, so many scriptures. You can understand him fully by reading Srimad Bhagavatam or Bhagavad Gita. You should try to reach each and every passage, at least one shloka every day, and understand its meaning. You should try to read the books given by ISKCON, because they are written by Srila Prabhupada, who is completely God conscious. That's why, and he was not without any material motive. That's why he can give this knowledge. You should all read at least one passage. So many novels, magazines, internet content, WhatsApp, Facebook content you are reading every day. You should read this as well every day. Then only you can. And first thing is that you should also chant this Hare Krishna Mahamantra. At least try to chant one round, but that in that one round, you put all your energy, because we don't know that whether you will be able to see your next life, whether you will be able to see your next day. We don't know. Life is so short. Maybe today may be our last day. So whatever one round, even if you are chanting, give your full energy on that round. You try to listen each and every syllable of this Hare Krishna Mahamantra clearly. You don't have to make your mind wander in some pastimes of Lord as well. What to speak about wandering your mind in some philosophical speculation. You just listen this Hare Krishna Mahamantra and you will get all purified. You will get the all understanding, because name of Krishna are non-different than Krishna. Then we have this last verse, the last passage, which is called preaching is the essence. So the duty of all sane men, anyone who is sane means who is not mad, because 99.99% are mad. They are just after pursuit of some happiness, which they just by their understanding, they can understand how much money they can made, everything they can made with the death, everything is going on. So they don't have this knowledge. They are all acting like a madman. So the duty of all sane men, one who is having little bit of intelligence, or one who is given this intelligence by some or the other way, by guru, by some disciplic succession, by some way or the other, by preaching, any sane man, the duty of that sane man is to save the people in general. So Parikshit Maharaj anxiously wanted to know from Sukhdev Goswami how humanity can be saved from gliding down to hell, because right now everyone is gliding to hell. So that's why you all are intelligent. I would request you all intelligent person, that all intelligent men must take advantage of these instruction. Unfortunately, however, the entire world is lacking this Krishna consciousness, and therefore people are suffering from the grossest ignorance and do not even believe in a life after this one. To convince them of their next life is very difficult, because they have become almost mad in their pursuit of material enjoyment. Nevertheless, our duty, the duty of all sane men, is to save them. So that's why all of your duty is at least to save yourself and to save others. Otherwise, we all in this age of Kali Yuga, with so much of gadgets to surround us every day, so much of Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, everything is there. We all are only mad in some or the other pursuit of material happiness, some or the other in Facebook and all. We are just thinking to get some or the other pleasure, but there is no pleasure. We are just hankering. So if some amount of Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, we can cut down and we can just chant this Hare Krishna Mahamantra, then your life is all perfect. Hare Krishna. So anyone having any question, then they can just raise it here by unmuting yourself. Anyone having any queries? Okay. You may even later call me in case someone want to discuss something personal, some or the other thing that they want to discuss, they can call me later as well. Some or the other spiritual queries that they have, I will be ready to answer them. So we'll end this session right now. Hare Krishna.